I'm here with Carolina Garza.
Yes.
So nice to meet you today.
Nice to meet you too.
Unfortunately, it was not under the best of circumstances.
Not really, but we made it better circumstances.
Yeah. So, and I met you today at the Collin County Courthouse.
Yes.
How many times have you been to that courthouse over the last number of years?
I could say that this at least has been like my 9th or 10th
mm-hmm.
time.
But this is not a situation that you're going to court. You're just going to be a support for your husband. Is that correct?
Exactly, yes.
Can you tell me a little bit about what's going on from your perspective? I mean, you're his wife.
Yes.
You have children together. You have stepchildren as well. Mm-hmm. Just give me your perspective on everything that takes place in the courts.
Well, so I'm, like you said, I'm there just to be a support to Robert through his case. His case has been going on for 10 years. But I've been part of his life for five, almost 6 years now.
Wow.
And it's very, very an unfortunate case. You know, it's very sad, and it's taken a lot of me to understand and try to be there for him
mm-hmm.
because I did not know that these things were going on in the system, in the world, and
right.
just could never comprehend. It's like a movie.
Right.
You know?
So can you give a little bit more details for those who don't know exactly what you're talking about?
About the case?
Yes, about the case. Whatever you're comfortable with.
Yeah, so my husband has two girls.
Okay.
And he was married before to somebody.
Okay.
Should I say names or no names?
Probably without name, just
okay.
another person, yeah.
Yeah, he was married to another person, and unfortunately, this person hates my husband and has not been able to move on after 10 years. And she has a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
And she is a woman that has a lot of influence through her business.
Mm-hmm.
So she has used all this power and money to just make my husband's life and my life impossible.
Mm-hmm. So you said that you've only been around for about 5 to 6 years
mm-hmm.
of this whole thing.
Yeah.
And that to you it was a bit of a surprise.
It was extreme surprise.
So you come from another country.
Yes.
How would it be handled? You come from Colombia, is that
yes.
correct?
Mm-hmm.
How would something like this be handled down in Colombia?
I don't ever think that even, I mean, something like this would even sustained there. I've never heard of anything like that. I just don't think people would last this long fighting.
Mm-hmm.
You know, mm-hmm. I really honestly think that you have to be extremely miserable
mm-hmm.
to fight for 10 years
mm-hmm.
and spend so much money and energy and put your kids through this for so long.
Yeah. So for the background, and tell me if I have everything correctly, this was a divorce situation. There are the two children involved. At one time, as I understood, at least for a very brief amount of time, everybody was okay. Things were going. It may have only been 2 months, but at least, you know, your husband, and this was probably prior to you meeting him, was seeing his girls and everything was fine. And then after the 61st day, everything changed. What happened at the 61st day that made things change?
So to my understanding, they had, you know, a pretty nice, you know, agreement that
mm-hmm.
they were just gonna part ways. You
mm-hmm.
know, they weren't understanding each other.
Mm-hmm.
And after the 61st day of the divorce, that Robert could not go after her assets,
mm-hmm.
she started filing all kinds of things against him.
Right, and as I talked with Robert, her assets were nothing that he was even interested in.
No.
But what she started to do then, as I understand, was to use the system to keep him away from the girls. Is that
yes,
correct?
Yes, exactly.
And looking at the calendar that I saw, it looked like immediately from day 61 until about day 120 or 180 or something like that, he was almost excluded from the children's lives.
Yes, completely.
And that's been an ongoing battle, as far as I understand. Is that correct?
Yes. Every summer, every holiday,
mm-hmm.
every opportunity that she gets, she will take.
Mm-hmm. So I want to ask you a couple of questions
mm-hmm.
first. You're his wife right now.
Yes.
What type of a strain has this put upon your relationship? Obviously, I mean, I would think that probably when you married Robert, you weren't quite expecting this level of drama. If you could call it drama is probably a nice word.
Mm-hmm.
But what type of a strain has it put on your relationship?
It's put a very big strain on my marriage, mm-hmm. because although he's my husband and I understand what he's going through, it's not ultimately for him to make a choice on it. He
right.
can't, you know, choose, because he has to respond mm-hmm. to it because they're his kids and he loves them.
Mm-hmm.
It's extremely hard because I have also been put in the middle of it.
Right.
You know, there's all this hatred against me because I love these kids unconditionally,
right.
because they are his kids and because I've grown a bond with them,
right.
and I take care of them. So now I'm hated for it. I'm bullied for it.
Hmm.
And it takes a lot of time for me and him because he's constantly trying to defend his case
right.
and trying to defend his kids.
Yeah, yeah. It does create a lot of difficulty. But, you know, from what I hear, you had a very good relationship with his children.
I did have a very good relationship with, I still have a very good relationship with his younger daughter, too.
Mm-hmm.
His older daughter, until 6 months ago, we had an extremely close relationship too. And now that she's growing and she's 13, it's been a little bit of a struggle.
So some people have talked about this whole issue that you're talking about in a couple of different ways. They've used terms like parental alienation, toxic parenting, a number of things like that. But I want to focus on the children for a moment here. The older of the two children, do you think that she's acting as her true self, or do you think somehow she's being manipulated or even victimized?
Completely. I think that she's completely learned her behavior from her mother.
Mm-hmm.
I think she wants to also support her mother.
Mm-hmm.
I think she also feels that she gets a lot of attention from her mom
mm-hmm.
because she's siding with her.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, there's the money and the power
mm-hmm.
too. That's when you start growing and you see what
right.
what comes along with you playing along with the person that's providing those things,
mm-hmm.
you know, you become very manipulative
mm-hmm.
of situations.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, if, you know, 10 years is going to be too much time for a kid to go under the stress.
Right, right. I mean, basically, if she's 13 right now in 10 years, that's by far the majority of her life.
Exactly.
Do you think, I mean, you've seen this, and again, you've had a good relationship with her, but there's got to be that pull, that stress, that strain.
She has said many times that she just wants to be away from both parents because she's so stressed that she feels that she's put in the middle of
right.
both of them and that she has to pick a side.
Mm-hmm.
So what I always tell her is that she just needs to be a child and worry about children stuff
right.
and not about adult stuff. And we pray about it. And I just try to keep her preoccupied on love and just other things.
Mm-hmm.
But the older she gets, the more she understands and the more that she gets involved.
Right, right. And I imagine that as she's getting older too, it's got to be having impacts or effects on her, perhaps in her social life, perhaps in school. Have you seen anything along those lines as well?
Oh, of course. She is in all kinds of trouble at school and with other kids, and her relationships are really hard for her too,
mm-hmm.
because she is so stressed, sad, and her feeling frustration.
Mm-hmm.
This is mostly what I see in both girls. It's so much frustration.
Right.
Because they can't do anything to fix it.
Right.
This has been my most strong feeling, and my daughter's most feeling is frustration,
mm-hmm.
because there's nothing we can do to help them.
Right, right. As much as your heart goes out to them, there's nothing that you can do.
Mm-hmm.
So when you look at, in particular, looking at the girls here, there's several different hearts at play. There's their heart toward their father. There's their mother's heart towards the father, which is not in the best of condition, or at least doesn't express the nicest of sentiments. But then you have the hearts of the parents toward the children. I'm sure that your husband, as the father, just aches to have that relationship.
Yes.
I think for you, on the other hand, you would also ache, but you see things from a different perspective as well. Is that correct?
Yes, totally. You know, he just hurts and hurts, and he just wants to give and give and give and fix and fight. And I my perspective, I'm extremely worried on so many aspects.